I think every place has a reason that they contribute to the overall ecosystem of the planet. Doug and I started camping in the Chacabuco Valley in 1994. In South Chile, it's very wild. That said, there was a lot of pressure on the rivers, the forests, because of timber and ranching.
Valle Chacabuco was a typical sheep ranching farm. There were more sheep, more cows than the area was able to support.
We had the idea, if we buy this land, it would take it out of the threat of production. Maybe we can donate it and make new national parks, something that belonged to all Chileans.
The transition of a livestock ranching to become a national park contributes to a new perspective about the use of this land. We need to learn from our mistakes and reorientate what we are doing.
Once we understood that we could change the outcome of these territories long term, that's what motivated us and that's what guided us. In 1997, we decided to go up to northern Argentina to the country's largest wetlands. We realized that key species were missing. That changed the nature of our work.
We still need to protect the wild places that are left, but that is not enough anymore. Now it's time to restore.
Over the last 30 years, we've been able to create 13 new national parks, 15 million acres. But the thing that makes me the proudest are the team members who now have become Rewilding Chile and Rewilding Argentina. In another generation or so, you're not going to hear the Tompkins name.